Scott Football, the head coach of the Highland Park Scots, and Ray Gaskin. Brought to you in part by Ellen Terry Realty. Ellen Terry outscores the rest because Ellen Territory has no boundaries.
Hello again, everybody. Welcome to Scots Football. Ray Gaskin with Randy Emery. The Highland Park football season ended on Friday night as the Scots lost a heartbreaker 14-13 to the Paris Wildcats over in Garland. And Coach, all I can think of to start it off is it was, to me, a case of Murphy's Law. What could go wrong seemed to go wrong that night.
Yeah, it did. Our kids played their hearts out, and I just wish that we could have been playing one more week. And they had a great year, and we had a tremendous bunch of seniors, and I really want to pay tribute to them. They did a great job.
Let's start off and talk a little bit about the weather conditions. You know, you mentioned on the show last week you liked the stadium over there. You've had great luck playing over in Garland in the past, but we get over there the other night, it's extremely windy. And it also started raining during a ball game, so the weather conditions were less than ideal. Of course, I know you can turn around and you can say, well, you know, Paris had to play in that weather, too.
That's right. Really, you know, the rain was no factor, and it only rained for just a few minutes, and it not hard at that. The wind blew for both teams.
Yeah.
And
seemed to blow some of their passes, though, that didn't seem like they were going to be caught right into their hands. And there was cases, though, where Lady Luck came into play.
I'll tell you what, Parrish, my hat's off to them. They played well. They played hard, extremely hard, as our kids did. And when we came out in the second half and really got to rolling, and we were in control of the ball game.
I really thought you had them then. Of course, everybody, I think, did on the Highland Park side.
They didn't let down. And even after they scored, I thought we were going to come back and win the ball game because all we needed was a field goal. But old Lady Luck on that kick, they were trying to kick a hard squib on the ground. Kid got it up just a little bit, and it was so hard that one of our guys up front just he couldn't get out of the way.
Just a split second, and the ball just came in hard and ricocheted right off him.
And that hurt us because it took away field position, it took away time on the clock,
right.
And we just couldn't recover from it.
That it, you know, it isn't fair for me to draw too many conclusions from the injury standpoint, but without knowing that maybe somewhere along the line this season, Paris may have lost three or four top players. But you have had the injury problems as the season has gone along. And the other night, you had two guys who were out there playing who got shaken up during the ball game. I know Mark Falk was playing it with an extremely sore arm, and that got hurt in the second quarter, and yet he came back and played, and Edward Herring had to go out for a while.
Yeah, both those kids have a lot of mental toughness, and maybe some other kids might have stayed out, but this bunch of kids were very tough, and they showed their toughness, and they came back and played.
All right, we'll take our first break here. We'll come back and begin to look at the action from the football game. We're not going to call it highlights necessarily, but there was a lot of action and a lot of very unusual plays, a lot of key plays throughout the ball game, and we'll start with that after this.
Some things are worth that extra effort. Real Texas Barbecue is one of them. And every Coulter's location gives that extra effort to serve you only the finest barbecue around. It's juicy, full of flavor. And now Coulter's Catering will make your next party or get-together more than just a good time. We'll serve it for you. Or prepare it so that you can serve it yourself. With all the side dishes, desserts, and that famous Coulter's Barbecue. For more information, just dial 817-COLTERS. Coulter's, with 10 area locations, or just one phone call away.
At Coulter's, Coulter's Barbecue.
Mmm. Max and Mahoney Turner, a full-service insurance agency. But what does full service mean for you? No matter what field you're in, from manufacturing to real estate, electronics to energy, Max and Mahoney Turner can provide services that go beyond just insurance needs. Max and Mahoney Turner's personal line of insurance services include auto and homeowners, boat, personal umbrella, and even coverage for seasonal dwellings. And because of its size, Max and Mahoney Turner has carrier draft authority and is quite often able to provide in-house payments for many automobile and homeowner claims. Max and Mahoney Turner, where insurance is a profession and service is a way of life.
Tradition, style, a way of life. But there's more than just winning to the Scott traditions. The Park Cities News, celebrating 50 years of service to the Park Cities and the second year of a new Scott tradition. Award-winning sports reporter, Matt McKay. More than just the usual. Matt McKay combines the usual with the bold, the daring, the unusual. For the serious, McKay. For the lighthearted, McKay. For the Park City sports enthusiast, it's Matt McKay. From the sideline, the press box, and the locker room. But only in the Park City's News.
All right, we'll begin looking at the action now. Highland Park against the Paris Wildcats over at Homer Johnson Stadium in Garland. And as is always the case this season, Scott's kicking off to start the game, Coach.
I'll tell you what, our coverage team just did a great job. There's Whit Peterman, he's down there almost every kickoff. And I'll tell you what, boy, the Paris Wildcats came out and fired up, and they're going a pretty good drive here.
They're at the 22-yard line here, picking up 5 yards on the first down. Carry Battle goes for 8 yards on the second play from scrimmage. It's a first and 10 at the 30-yard line for Paris. Quick pitch to Robinson here. They had some versatility in the backfield, didn't they?
Had a lot of quickness.
Well, you know, you've said it throughout the season. One of the things that you pointed out, Coach, before the year started was that in this 4A realignment that you're in, you were going to see a lot of very fast and very talented running backs, and that certainly has been the case.
Yes, it sure has. Pretty good defense in there right there.
Now, Paris continuing to move, but the going has gotten a lot tougher here at the moment. They're out at the 43-yard line, sweeping it around the right side this time. Henderson coming forward for 9 to the Scots 48. It'll be second down and 1. I believe they're going to break a pretty long gainer right here.
Tell you what, we lost containment there, and that cornerback, awfully quick.
Dillard.
I tell you what, their backs just did an outstanding job of blocking.
Okay, after Dillard runs for 17, Battle stacked up for 3, second and 7. It's Battle again, and Scott's trying to stop him.
Key Battle, isn't that a great name for a football player?
It sure is.
He's also a defensive end. He's going to be highly recruited.
It's time they got it strong to the left side, and Battle gets a few more as Paris is getting down there to knock on the door at 17-yard line.
Oh, I tell you what, there is another great play by Sloan Wilson. Just a tremendous play.
Yeah, let's see what happens here. Second down, 11, ball at the 20-yard line. Battle, whoops, can't take it to the outside, keeps it inside, but it'll be third down and 8 for the Wildcats. And a good job of stringing out the play and forcing him out of bounds.
Here comes a big play, fourth down play, and Drew Small comes through on the linebacker
nice
blitz, and just a great call by the coaches and a great job by Drew Small.
That was a fourth down and 3. That was a 15-play drive for the Paris team, but they come up empty-handed on the great defensive stop there and the loss of 3 on fourth down. We have another look.
Just a great open field tackle there by Drew Small.
So the 15 plays result in no points for Paris. Scott's take over at the 15-yard line. First down, here comes Mark Falk. And then on second down, 5, ball at the 20-yard line. Edward Herring this time. And whoops, a lot of quickness here in the Paris defense. But going to get a nice gain right here, Coach.
Yeah, it sure is. Here's a good
Good block on the 42.
Good block by Joby Fortune and an outstanding run by Mark Falk that gets us out of a big hole.
Well, it takes you from the 20 up to the 48-yard line. Let's have another look. Gain of 28 on the play. And we couldn't see the block there from that angle, but it certainly cleared the path for Falk to go for 28 yards. Wouldn't it be nice if you could just, you know, do that at will?
Yeah.
Short gain on this play. Ball up to the 50-yard line. Second down, 8. Let's go with Falk again.
Tell you what, this next play, we're going to come on a draw play, and just a good job of blocking by a quick side of our offensive line, and also a good block in there by Joby Fortson once again. And now we're in pretty good field position, and we're going to bring out something new. And Parrish is pretty confused, but
whoops,
they're just slightly overthrown, and their defensive back makes a great interception and a good return, and we didn't get any points out of a pretty good offensive effort.
This is the replay on it. Johnson making the interception over the shoulder pickoff by the Parris defensive back, and he brings it all the way out to the 34-yard line. So, Parris on the attack again. Game is still scoreless.
Oh, good. Whoa. Gosh, is that not a big hit? Is that
Weidman with a big hit there. Game still scoreless as the clock winding down in the first quarter. Young is tackled here.
Tell you what, just
Small Wilson Fair all in there.
Just great effort there by our...
Let's get him again. And you do, a loss of 1. Outstanding defensive series by the Scots there. Sets up fourth down, 4th and 40-yard line, and Andrew Woodward on the receiving end of the punt. And you got pretty good field position here again.
Yeah, we sure do. The first quarter, they had a good drive. We had a good drive. Didn't result in any.
Boy, look at that. Here we go around the corner again. Falk with Andrew Woodward now in at quarterback.
Right.
So that gets you to the 30-yard line.
Edward hurt his shoulder on the pass where it was intercepted, and they do a great job of stringing out. I'll tell you what, their defense is just tremendously quick.
Second down 10, last play of the first quarter. Falk. Nice pickup of 8 yards, though, down to the 23-yard line as the first period draws to a close. So Parris has driven 15 plays, got no points on the board. You've had 2 drives, and you have to feel like the momentum is shifting around to your side.
Yeah, we were in pretty good shape right here at the end of the first quarter. We're down there knocking on the door, and they had a penetration, and we either have one or we're about to get one. And that's going to tie things up, and that's the first tiebreaker. We're in good shape. We've got to get some points out of it now.
All right, we'll take a break here, and we'll come back with the second quarter of action right after we pause for this.
Ellen Terry Realtors is witnessing a new beginning in places other than just on the football field. The Dallas real estate market has begun to move with positive momentum, and the Ellen Terry team is ready to help you move with it. Every team has downtime, but it's the dedicated, qualified professionals who climb to the top. And with a team built around integrity, honesty, credibility, and service to the public, Ellen Terry Realtors remains at the top of their game. Ellen Territory knows no boundaries. Recently scoring the prestigious exclusive affiliations with both the Estate Club and Sotheby's, the premier international residential real estate brokerage. Ellen Terry Realtors has shown the world what tenacity, dedication, hard work, and a positive, can-do attitude will achieve. Ellen Terry Realtors, another established Park City's tradition with a new beginning.
Move 'em on, hit 'em up, hit 'em up, move 'em on, hit 'em up, raw hide. Let 'em out, ride 'em in, let 'em out, cut 'em out, ride 'em in, raw hide.
Beef. Beef on the hook. And beef on the platter. If you want the best beef on a platter, or fajitas, or fried catfish, then it's K-Bob Steakhouse. K-Bob's, with a menu of more than just steak, soup, and salad. K-Bob's has the best beef on a platter. But if you want to see the best beef on the field, we'll see you at the game.
We pick up the second quarter action. Scots are facing a 3rd down and 2 at the Parris 22-yard line. As we go left to right here in the second quarter. And, Coach, you're going to get the first down.
Yeah, here's a a nice job of blocking by our strong side, and Joby hammers it up there for 5 yards and gets the first down. We're going to come on a play action pass now, and we just absolutely turn their defensive end loose. Just one of those things, and we had the kid wide open, and then we have a bad pitch, and now we're going, we're down there on the 17-yard line, and all of a sudden, we're on the 42.
And it is third down and 34 yards to go. Keeping it on the ground here, no gain, so an opportunity goes awry for the Scots. Fourth down and 34 yards to go. And here's the punt from the 41. Fair catch, and we got interference coming?
Yeah, we interfered with their kicker. You have to give him a couple of yards room, and we didn't. And it just cost us 5 yards there.
Now, there's a fumble, though, on this first down play. Boy, it sure would have been nice to recover that one, but the Wildcats got it back. Second down, 7 at the 22. How about this play
right there? Oh, I'll tell you what, is that not a great tackle by Britt Fair? Just a great open field tackle.
Here's another look at it, and here he comes. Boom, at the 20-yard line. A loss for Paris. Third down and 8 yards to go at the 21-yard line. And let's see if Paris can pick up the first down. I don't think they're going to do it. Of course, I was at the game, and I had it on the sheet, so I know they're not going to do it.
All right. After that first drive, our defense settled in, and they haven't gotten anything.
And they're not going to pump the ball real well here either. It's a boot of 28 yards, and there it takes the bounce laterally out of play. Ball is at the 49-yard line of Paris. Good field position again for the Scots, but what happens here?
Yeah, that, we've turned the ball twice and taken a big loss when we had great field position, and we made too many mistakes in that first half. If we could have gotten one field goal out of our three opportunities, we win the ball game by two.
Well, Whiteman comes through, though, with a real big hit on the first down play, second down 9 at the 46, and look at this.
Well, I tell you what, here is just a great job of stringing it out by Mikey Edwards.
Great tackle.
Outstanding defensive play.
So, just like that, it's now third down and 13 yards to go from the 42-yard line. Dillard, the quarterback, rolling right, looking, and he's going to keep it. Shakes the tackle, still on his feet, but not enough for a first down.
Here comes a big play. They run a fake punt.
And there it is right there, and woo, they go straight up the middle. Of course, the kicker acting like the ball is snapped over his head to play out that little bit of theater, and works for Paris. They get the first down at the 43-yard line, so they're still alive.
Our defense is really playing outstanding football.
Hitting very hard. Second down, 4 at the 37-yard line. Battle getting the pitch again. Paris with all that speed and quickness in the backfield, taking advantage of it. First and 10 at the 31. Here's a big play for Paris.
Yeah, they come on a pass, and it was just a perfectly thrown pass. We're covering it in as bad good a position as you could be.
Sure are. Here's another look at it. The roll to the left, perfectly thrown ball. Had off that catch, and they're down at the 1 yard line. So Paris about to take the lead here. First and goal at the 1 yard line. No score in a ball game. Both teams have moved the ball quite a bit in the game, and now Paris able to get it into the end zone, get the extra point, and they lead 7-0. 3:56 to go in the first half. And there's that ball hopping across the turf.
Yep, that's the way.
Have they been doing that all year? Is that the way they? Is that the way they do it all the time?
On the turf, they do.
When they're playing on the rug, they like to watch the ball bounce. So, all right. We're back at the 13-yard line now, and Brandon Michong is in the ball game. As you saw earlier, Mark Falk went out with that injury.
There's a fine run by Brandon. Another outstanding block by Joby Ford.
Third down, 7 at the 24, and the pass.
I'll tell you what, Andrew had his man beat, and it was just overthrown. And I'll tell you what, he's going to get big, big yardage and maybe even score on that. And we just needed a break, and we didn't get it.
Just couldn't get it. On the punt, Paris takes over. They've got it at the 46-yard line, first and 10. And here they come again. That defense is hanging in there tough. Second down, 4 at the 40-yard line of the Scots. Power football here by Paris. Now, we've got a first and 10 at the 35. We need to have something happen defensively.
Yeah,
you do.
I'll tell you what, Malcolm Ferguson and Sloan Wilson conversion on the quarterback throwing for a big loss.
Second and 14 at the 39, Robinson.
Oh,
slung down hard by Drew, Small.
Is that Drew?
Yes.
Boy, I tell you what, Drew's having an outstanding ball game.
Third and 10 at the 35, Paris has got to connect. They're going to here as Dillard will find Harrison for 15.
Oh, golly, that was a collision. That
Edwards with
Mikey
a big
Edwards
hit.
And the receiver.
In fact, this is worth a second look. Well, Paris completing almost all of their passes from a rollout formation.
Yeah, they like to get the quarterback out there because he's so dangerous. If he can't throw, he can run.
Edwards for Paris rambles down to the 12-yard line, second down and three. Time running out in the first half. Can Paris get some more points on the board, leading 7-0? The pass tipped, incomplete. Third down and three from the 13. And he threw that one away. Let's have a flag there. How about a little flag? Let's move that thing back.
Tell you what, that was some heat coming in there. Who was it?
Wilson putting the heat on. Now on fourth down, a field goal try by Paris, but it is no good. So the Scots dodge a bullet, and time for one play. Clock runs out in a first half at 7-0. You know, I'm sure you had mixed emotions about the way that unfolded in the first half.
Well, you know, Parrish went on a fine drive to open the game, and then our defense stiffened and held them. And then we had a couple of big runs by Mark Falk, and we got down there, and you know, we came right back, and then threw an interception, and then our defense held, and we had another opportunity. We got down on the 17-yard line, and we turned somebody loose and got sacked, and then we had a bad pitch, and we wound up having to punt if we could have just gotten a field goal there. But then our defense held and gave us great field position around midfield.
Sure did.
And then Mark, who has a bum elbow, he gets hit right on that elbow, and after a six-yard gain, you know, and we give the ball right back to him. So,
well, that was an extremely painful hit that he took, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it sure was. You know, he just hit him right where he's
right on
hurt.
The soft spot.
And anyway, we had three opportunities in the first half and got no points out of it. And if we could have just gotten a field goal out of one of those, but that's the way it is.
Well, I guess, you know, the other side of that coin is there's a heads and a tails, and over there in the Paris locker room, I guess they're over there sitting there thinking, good grief, we had the ball down there, we missed a field goal, we could have scored another one here or there. So, you know, two different ways to look at it, but by the same token, you're only behind 7-0, and you're going to come out and get it cranked up in the second half.
Yep, sure do. And kids, you know, my hat's off to them. Defense just, you know, just played extremely well, and if you take away that one pass that was perfectly thrown, and,
mm-hmm.
you know, and we were in pretty good shape, but
sure
it
were.
Was just perfectly thrown. Who knows?
Well, let's take a break here. We'll come back with more of this week's show in a minute.
There's a word for news like this. Emotional. Leadership. It's working in the spirit of Texas.
Art. More than just oil on canvas. More than the ability to mold bronze into sculpture. Art is the transformation of ordinary materials into extraordinary masterpieces. In business, as in art, only a few have the ability, the creativity, the drive to transcend the ordinary. But in Dallas, there is a bank. North Park National Bank, Dallas' largest independent banking company. North Park has the creativity to see what can be, the ability to share in your vision. From trust and investment services to automobile leasing, from multi-million dollar commercial loans to home mortgages, from the exclusive services provided by private banking to lending on investments in fine art. North Park National Bank is where the art of banking has become a lasting Dallas tradition.
Well, not only was this the final football game of the season for the Scots, but Coach, the last opportunity for the band, the drill team, the cheerleaders to perform, and you know, there's a lot of disappointment for them too when the season comes to an end.
Yeah, we'd already met with the Dallas people, and we were going to play the T.J. Hillcrest winner, which turned out to be T.J., and we had lost the flip. And it was not a flip that I minded losing. We flipped neutral sites. We named Homer B. Johnson, and the Dallas people named the Cotton Bowl. And we had a great experience in 86 there against Carter. And our coaches and our kids were really looking forward to going to the Cotton Bowl, and I'm just sorry, especially for our seniors, they didn't get the opportunity to go there.
Well, and as we pointed out, of course, the band, the drill team, the Highland Bells, they're disappointed they won't be able to go too, but they've had an outstanding season also. And on our last show of the year tonight, we're going to feature the Highland Bells under the direction of Kathy Wheat. Let's have a look.
Wheat is the drill team director. Tell us about your responsibilities with the drill team.
To choreograph, to get the routines ready for the field, to do counseling, to answer questions, solve problems, just a jack of all trades.
What is the selection process for the girls?
The girls have to try out in front of independent judges, four girls at a time, and they learn a jazz routine and do kicks and splits, and then the judges make their decision.
I guess when that practice process is going on to try to make the drill team, there are a lot of nervous moments for some young ladies.
A lot of tears, a lot of nervous moments for mothers also that wait outside to find out the results. But everyone pulls for everyone, so there's a good spirit there too.
How do you go about the selection process of the judges, because there is so much at stake?
The judges have all been directors for several years, rangerettes, dance majors, and have extensive background in judging.
Now, I'm sure that the girls who make the drill team didn't just decide a couple of weeks before that they want to try out for it. What's the typical background?
Starting classes in the fourth grade, drill team preparation classes, dance classes, and continuing on through the time that they try out.
I know the football players are pretty nervous on Friday night when they come out to play a game. I'd have to think that the girls are the same way.
Yes, they are. They get really uptight right before halftime, and it's impossible to even get their attention.
What would you consider the high point of the year each season in terms of which performance would seem to stand out over the others?
The first performance every year is the most important to them, the first football game.
How much practice time goes into preparing each week?
We practice from 7 to 8:30, that's before school, and then from 8:30 to 9 after school starts. So 2 hours a day approximately.
Well, thank you very much, and good luck.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Wesley Bowman. Hi, I'm Jennifer Talley.
Hi, my name's Elizabeth Hepler.
Hi, I'm Melissa Brown.
Hi, I'm Sarah Hepler.
Hi, I'm Stephanie Martin.
Hi, I'm Catherine Fisher.
Take it, baby.
I'm Lott McElhinney. Back in 1978, I played running back for the Highland Park Scots. Today, I play for another special team, Colwell & Son on Hillcrest. Like the Scots, Colwell & Son is a tradition in Highland Park. We were founded 68 years ago by W.E. Colwell and are still owned and operated by the Colwell family. Colwell & Son features classic styling and traditional apparel for men, boys, and ladies. Come see us at the Hillcrest store, Valley View, Preston Park, or the Galleria.
Back in 1884, a printing shop opened in Dallas called the Dorsey Company. Today, you know it as the Williamson Printing Corporation, the largest commercial printer in Texas. It's a big plant now with state-of-the-art technology, but the focus here is still on quality. From stationery to corporate financial reports, legal and financial services to award-winning commercial printing. One of Dallas's oldest is still one of the very best. Williamson Printing Corporation, 6700 Denton Drive, across from Love Field.
Good morning, Dallas. What's your sport? Good morning, Dallas. What's the report?
Welcome back, everybody. Coach, before we take a look at the highlights of the second half, you know, with the playoffs underway, a lot of unusual things going on. Strange game between Mesquite and Samuel the other night. But what about that that very odd sequence of events involving Dallas Carter with South Grand Prairie going to be in the playoffs as a replacement, then not in the playoffs against Plano East? Heart really goes out for those South Grand Prairie kids who were told on, Thursday night late, they hustled out, they have a midnight practice. Then the next morning, somebody says, oh, wait a minute, guess what, you're not going after all.
You know, you had two schools that were on an emotional yo-yo there. Carter, they were up, ready to play, and then down, then up again. South Grand Prairie, not even having a thought of anything, and then
until 11th hour,
until Thursday afternoon,
they had to go get the football equipment out of the lockers. I think I read where the band director said, "My gosh, we sent all the uniforms off to the cleaners, have them clean. How are we going to get the uniforms back in time for the game tomorrow night?"
Anyway, so they make some last minute preparations and get ready to play, and then they're told they're out. So I tell you what, that was a situation where I really felt sorry for Carter at first, then South Grand Prairie, and it'll be interesting to see what happens this week. This is one of those unfortunate deals. This is a deal where the coaches, checked grades. The kid had been turned a grade in. What had happened was he transferred out of one class into another class, and apparently the teacher, just took the grades that he made in his or her class and didn't go back and get the grades that, from the class that he had transferred out of. And it was my understanding that it was a level change. He went from an algebra class to a pre-algebra class,
right,
which is a lower level. Well, the classes aren't the same, and they're very extenuating circumstances here, and I don't know as a coach what you could have done, because you've got the grades, you look at the grades say that the kid was passing.
I think you also, Freddie James over there, he runs a very clean program, and certainly would not run the risk by using a player that might be found out ineligible later. Wouldn't run that kind of risk,
right,
if he knew that player was ineligible.
And there was no pressure brought to bear on the teacher, and it was just one of those unfortunate things, and a whole team was being penalized for perhaps some oversights for the teacher.
And then South Grand Prairie gets on the roller coaster, but don't forget Plano East, too. You know, the coach over there, Coach Bailey at Plano East, said, you know, we've been getting all revved up, fired up, ready to play Carter. Our kids have a mindset of we're going to play Carter. Then all at once, they say, oh, you're going to play South Grand Prairie instead. And they're going, you know, who? And so that was very disconcerting for everybody, and just an unfortunate set of circumstances.
It was a, it's a distraction. I'll tell you, for Plano East, it was a distraction, and I don't know that they could have beaten Carter if there had been no distractions. But as a coach, you'd certainly like to take your chances.
Well, the no pass, no play, the intent of all that is of course, you know, by the letter, is quite good. Want the youngsters to go to school, get an education. The extracurricular activities are fine, but let's make sure that we got our priorities straight. And yet, there are some holes in that whole process. That you know, I'm going to try to get into a political thing here, but this was a good example the other night of some of the odd and very emotional things that can happen.
Well, I've been an opponent of our particular system since its inception 3 years ago. Because I, you know, Perot and his people thought that this no pass, no play rule that they came up with would create a better educated kid. And my argument has that it has promoted mediocrity. Kimbrough, who at Plano, he hasn't said much about this until they were affected this year. I hadn't said anything in the past. But he basically said the same thing, and I agree. It encourages kids to take less challenging courses, and
so that they don't run the risk of getting a non-passing grade in something that might be a tough subject for them.
You can talk to coaches all over the state. You can talk to parents all over the state, and that's been the situation.
Yeah.
And I have a problem with that. I think that. There ought to be some margin, you know, whether it's an overall passing grade or whether the kid's passing for the semester. You know, I don't have any problem with a no pass, no play rule. I just don't particularly like the way we have it set up.
Well, let's see if there'll be some changes between now and next year on down, on down the road. They'll be talking about this thing again after the playoffs are over because of what did happen there. Let's get our attention back to the football game now. Scott's trailing 7-0 as we go to the second half. And as Randy pointed out, Scott's are going to look a lot different here in the third quarter. What'd you say to those guys at halftime?
Well, we, you know, it was just business as usual. There were no emotional outpourings.
It's the Athletic Supply play of the game.
Here is a big play of the game, perhaps maybe the offensive play of the game.
Terrific.
34-yard run by Edward. I don't know if that was bigger than the touchdown or not. Here we're going to come on a shift, and we're going to come on a quarterback draw, and Edward picks up about 5 yards here.
Nice call right there. And you know, different look there in the backfield. You're going with some, no back, you know, no setback look. Had some different, different looks in the game.
You know, we wanted to try to move their people around a little bit. Here is a good job of executing by Edward, and I think this is a touchdown play. And
oh, a nice move right there, and a somersault into the end zone from 11 yards out for the score. What a methodical and very quickly executed drive, Coach. Only about 5 plays.
Well, it was a great read by Edward. I'd have to say that would be the offensive play of the game. That was a good job by, I don't know if it was Blue Atwood or Michael Doherty down there occupying their cornerback that allowed Edward to get the last yard or two.
PAT is good. We got a new ball game. 9:38 to go. Third quarter game is tied 7-7. There's a lot of excitement and enthusiasm on the Highland Park side. And here is the kickoff. Taken by Paris, and they're not going to get out there very far, Coach, and there's a lot of hitting going on down there right now.
Once again, I believe that was Blazing Jason Gentry.
Sure was.
In on the cover. Oh, boy, our defense is swarming.
Swarming, gang tackling, led by Small and Edwards. Second down, 7 at the 28. Whoa, there's a loose ball on the turf.
I believe it was Chris Cooper that comes up with the ball. And, boy, we are in outstanding field position. At this point,
there is another look at it. Cooper recovering.
At this point, I believe we're behind in penetration 3-2. So it's very important that we get across that 20-yard line. And we're going to do it on the first carry by Mark Falk.
First and 10 at the 23-yard line to give is to Falk back in there after going out with that injury in the first half. And he's got the penetration. So game tied on penetration. Second down, 5 at the 18. Let's go back this way. Good call right here, Coach, and some face guarding. Interference, quite obvious here.
I tell you what,
Harris.
We'd have had a touchdown right there, but Mark was throwing right into the teeth of the wind, and the ball just hung up a little bit. Edward had the cornerback beat.
First and 10 at the 12, and a loss of 7 here, but you do get the ball back at least.
Yeah, once again, you know, a touchdown right there instead of a field goal that we had to settle for would have resulted in a win. But it just wasn't to be, and I sure wanted us to be sure that we were going to get our field goal out of it, which we do.
Nice boot by Smith there on fourth down, 30-yard field goal on fourth down and 12, and that puts the Scots on top. 6:17 remaining third quarter. Island Park 10, Paris 7. A big turnaround here in the third period, and the kickoff.
I'll
and boy, Paris bobbling
is,
that ball down
ball
there.
Is bouncing around right there. And, boy, they are really bottled up.
They are in big trouble at the 14-yard line. You just, you know, the momentum has switched around. And, you know, I had the feeling, you know, being down there on the sidelines, like a lot of people did, if you could just get the ball back again, get another touchdown, you're going to have this game put away.
Yeah. Yep. Certainly was going to be in, iced.
Now, they're still back there in the shadow of their own goal line, and... here goes Dillard.
Just a great job of stringing the play out by our defense.
It's the Athletic Supply play of the game.
I think you're going to see a big sack coming in here by Thomas Lott. Boy,
great
I tell you
play
what,
coming
is,
right there.
He is
Boom.
Flying through there. A great sack by Thomas. They're going to have to punt the ball, and we're going to get excellent field position.
That was a third down and 7 at the 17-yard line. And here comes the quarterback, Dillard, and here comes Lott. And that is a big hit. So it's fourth down and 13 at the 11-yard line. Paris, nothing going right for them now. The Scots playing tough defense and also moving the ball offensively. And here is the boot. And it's kick. Not a great kick either, and they had the win there.
Nice return by Andrew. And, boy, we're in outstanding field position now.
Sure are.
38-yard line.
38-yard line, first and 10. Give us the Falk for 2. It's second down 8 at the 36 of Paris. Scots leading 10-7. 3 more, 3rd and 5. And there's Paris jumping offside. You get a little bonus play here because you know you're going to get the 5 yards or you get a longer gain. Yes, you get the longer gain. Keep the yardage. They'll climb the penalty and it's at the 24. Fortson for 5. This looks like you're going to take it right on down and push it in.
Yeah, I tell you what, we're operating pretty good right here.
3rd down and 4 at the 18-yard line. And let's go on down there and get another first down. You do. It's now 1st and 10 at the Paris 14-yard line, but things start to go a little sour right here.
Yeah, we bobble a snap there, and, you know, whenever you're playing knock-em-out John football, like we are at this point, to take, you know, to take a 2-yard loss on first down just really throws you out of sync. You need to make, you know, we're down here in 4-down territory,
mm-hmm.
and we really needed to make 3 or 4 yards on the first down play because then that gives us a lot of options. But we took, you know, we bobble a snap, and it's just another one of those quirks of the game.
Sure.
You know, if we get the touchdown there, we're going to win the game. And we had our opportunities the other night, and things just didn't quite go right.
Well, Paris in that third quarter had only 6 yards. In total offense in the third quarter. The Scots totally dominated it offensively and defensively. We'll watch the fourth quarter right after we pause.
Some things are worth that extra effort. Real Texas Barbecue is one of them. And every Coulter's location gives that extra effort to serve you only the finest barbecue around. It's juicy, full of flavor,
And now Coulter's Catering will make your next party or get-together more than just a good time. We'll serve it for you, or prepare it so that you can serve it yourself, with all the side dishes, desserts, and that famous Coulter's barbecue. For more information, just dial 817-COLTERS. Coulter's, with 10 area locations, or just one phone call away.
At Coulter's, Coulter's Barbecue.
The number one reason they play football in the Southwest Conference is to play in the Cotton Bowl on New Year's Day. The Aggies have been there the last 3 years. Watch HSC to see who celebrates in Dallas this year.
Sparkman Hillcrest, with a history dating back to pioneer days, continues to serve Dallas area families. Today, you'll find complete services at one location. The funeral home reflects the dignity people have come to associate with Sparkman Hillcrest, and the meticulously maintained cemetery and historic Hillcrest Mausoleum combine to create a lasting memorial to your loved ones. Sparkman Hillcrest, truly a Dallas tradition.
We start the fourth quarter. Scots are facing a third down, 12 yards to go. This is a very critical play in a ball game, Coach.
Edward just fired a, just almost perfect shot low into the outside. Andrew almost came up with it. But we get the field goal, and we're hit 13-7. And I thought that that was a very important field goal, because if we could get one more field goal, they'd have to score twice in order to beat us, and I didn't think they were going to score twice against their defense.
Sure didn't look like it. That's the way that defense was playing in the third quarter. Touchback on the kickoff as the Scots are now also playing with the wind advantage. First and 10 at the 20-yard line. Gain of 3 by Paris. Second down, 7 at the 23. Dillard to Fuller.
Nice throw by the quarterback in there, just finding the open man.
And starting to rain a little bit here, as they take the play back across the other way. Henderson picking up the yardage. And we've got, a third down and four here. Dillard looking. This was a very big play by Paris. Yeah. It was a third and four.
Tell you what, I think they're going to take a big loss on this next play.
First and 10 at the 47.
No, it's not this play.
But, a loss of two.
Yeah.
they all help at this point. It's second down and 12 at the 49. Dillard looking, can't find the receiver. He's going to step out of bounds right here with some help. So it's now third down and 9, and let's see what happens right here. He's throwing against the grain, and it's a 46-yard score.
A great throw into the wind, and
right into the teeth of the wind, too.
And, I thought still, 7:51, we got plenty of time. And then, boy, I'll tell you what, he kicks that line drive right into our
man. There you go.
And they come down with the ball, and this really hurt us field position-wise and time-wise.
So now Paris has the ball back. They also have suddenly regained the lead, and they're up 14-13. But that gang tackling, Scott's defense is not giving up.
I'll tell you what, our defense was outstanding the other night, and, if not for two plays, they don't get any points.
They're down to the 32-yard line here, and faced with a third down and 8. And how about that play right there? There is a big loss.
Yeah, that's Craig Wyman just having another of his outstanding nights.
There is another look at it. Excellent pursuit from the outside as Wyman makes it. That was actually a second down play. Now it's third down and 8 from the 34-yard line, and the Scots defense has got to come up with a big play. And here it comes right there.
This is Bruce Small coming through on the blitz that you saw that snuffed out their first drive. Blitz, a great call by Ben Tyler, and forces them to punt. And we make a little error in judgment here, and we really start off in a big, big hole.
From the 5-yard line after the fair catch, first and 10, inside 7 minutes to play now. Actually, down about 5 minutes left in the ballgame. Fortson for 5 yards. Second down, five at the 11. And Edward back to throw. Ooh, he takes a big hit as he releases the ball.
We had another missed assignment and turned somebody loose, and he gets blasted.
Now third and five, and got to have the first down here. Wonder what happened there.
Edward called audible, and I think that the receiver heard, you know, there was
just
a lot of
noise,
and the wind was
blowing,
and we probably got the wrong audible.
Okay, on the fourth down and five punt. Good pursuit by the Scots. Ball's at the 44-yard line. And Paris, of course, just wants to work on that clock, try to run that thing out. They get off to a good start here, picking up a few yards. Second down, six, or to 40. Here comes Henderson for a couple of very tough yards. Third down and four. Your defense has got to do it again,
yeah.
Randy.
Tell you what, and they do rise to the
occasion. Oh, boy, how about that?
Tell you what, just a fine tackle in there, and I couldn't tell who that was, but it looked like it could have been one of our secondary kids.
They stopped Henderson for a gain of only 2 yards on fourth down and two. Paris not going for it. They punt. Ball is out at the 22 after a very short kick. So you got a little bit of a break on that punt. First down pass is incomplete. Second and 10. What are we going to do here?
Well, we come up with a draw play, and we don't get much.
Now it's third down and nine at the 23. Herring turns it back inside. Boy, this is so close on this next play, Coach. It's fourth and four. You got to have the first down. It took them a long time to decide whether you had it or not.
Tell you what, pitch to Jovi, and he was really going for the first down.
Stretching out.
And just came up inches short. And
so,
that was just kind of sign of the night.
Yeah, Henderson picks up five and six. Just a few seconds left on the clock, and Paris is going to run it out here and win the game by 1 point. Quarterback falling down on the ball. So the Scots' last real gasp, last opportunity, goes awry when Fortson stretching out, trying to get the few extra inches for the first down. And, you know, I was on the opposite side of the field. He went out of bounds in front of the Paris bench, and but it had to have been extremely close because it took him a long time to measure and decide.
Just came up inches short, and it was a very disappointing end to a very disappointing game. You know, if you could take any of about eight plays and change one of them, that
one of the outcome would sure be different.
And my hat's off to Paris. They hung in there and they did what it took to win. And hope they have the best of luck.
All right, we'll wrap up the show after we take this break. So don't go away.
Hi, I'm Manning Shannon. At Northcutt, Cathy, and Houseman Insurance, we know it takes a full team effort for success, but we also recognize the effect of a superior individual effort. That's why we're proud to announce the Scott Offensive and Defensive Players of the Week. Number 52, Preston Knight, center. And number 43, Drew Small, linebacker. Congratulations.
Hello, I'm Ellen Terry. And I want to talk to you about drug and alcohol abuse. Are you aware that low self-esteem is one of the major contributors to the most dangerous issues?
I believe Ellen has done for the city of Dallas what Betty Ford did for the nation, and that is speak out. I know that she personally, as well as professionally, has given of herself to this community and to combating this disease.
We at the Chemical Awareness Council are really excited about having the chance this year to participate with Ellen Terry and co-sponsor the Awareness Hour programs, which are going to be held monthly at Highland Park High School.
I know that parents need to stay involved in the lives of their children because sometimes there's problems that kids can't handle alone.
And because our children are important, I want to ask you to join me and others in a contest where the outcome isn't just posted on the school board. It's the lives of our children and the future of our community.
Something special happens when people show up on your doorstep. Park City's people, that is. See familiar faces and discover exotic places. Know what's up and who's who. From fashion finds to business minds. Hot spots to Highland Park Scots. Special monthly features from travel tales to real estate sales. To get all this now, you have to subscribe. You don't want to miss people showing up on your doorstep. Get 52 issues of Park City's People for just $19.
The only way to travel is traveler's style.
Some people want more.
Not just a little bit. This is your life.
And you're the only one who's living it.
Let's go. Let's live it. Love every mile. The only way to travel is traveler's style.
Roger Meyer Cadillac delivers the Cadillac lifestyle. From Elante to the Sedan DeVille. Your satisfaction is to Roger Meyer what tradition is to Highland Park, the road to success.
The only way to travel is Cadillac style.
Scott Football would like to thank the following special sponsors. Joe and Colleen Boudreau, Mickey and Susan Chandler, I.C. Deal, David L. Fair, Mike and Sharon McCullough, Mike Schmidt, Joe Worsham, Cornerstone Bank, the First National Bank of Park City, Larry Lang Jaguar, and Crossland Investment Properties.
Welcome back, everybody. Coach, I guess, you know, you could call it, you know, if we were trying to capsulize this season, come up with a name for it, something like just inches short or inches shy or something like that, because there were so many instances this year, not only in this game that you mentioned a moment ago, where if you could pick any one of 8 plays, the outcome of the game would be different. You could say that about, I think, all of the losses, with a possible exception of Grand Prairie, and even in that one, they only won 14-0.
Yeah, I think if you could turn just one play in the Paris game, we win.
You could sure say that about the Denison game, and we know which play that was at the end of the ball game.
Yeah.
And you could pick any one of a half a dozen more.
Yeah, you know, the first touchdown that was called back against holding when Edward broke against Denison. You could turn one play in the Ennis game.
You bet.
This team could have easily been 10-1 and deserved to be, you know, that good. We had one of the best defenses that we've had since I've been associated with Highland Park, and this is my 19th year. I think it was the best. You know, we've had some better individual players maybe, but this group, just as a group, they were outstanding. I tell you what, the offensive line did a great job, and you know, who could ask for more than what Edward and Mark did? It was just a fun year. We had a truly outstanding group of seniors. Great leadership by our captains, Drew Small and Blake Cecil and Edward Herring. We had a very unselfish group of kids, and I want to say that we had maybe the most unselfish group of parents that I've been around. They were just all in there wanting you to do your best and for you, and just a great group to be around. And
you say your phone wasn't ringing a lot on Saturday mornings with you know, with with all of the amateur quarterbacks.
I had one call, but outside of that,
I'd say that's pretty good if you only had one or two, you know, for a whole season.
But you know, the sports club, just led by Bob Cecil and his crew, just very supportive, and just, you know, they were just so great to work with. And I really want to mention two guys that helped us put this program together. Without their help, there were several people that helped, but without Ward Huey and David Turner, we couldn't have got off the ground. And they just, I really want to thank those two guys publicly. And for our seniors, I'm sorry it's over with, but it was great. I appreciate them letting me ride along on their coattails. Our juniors have a hard act to follow, and I tell you where our seniors were so great. They started it last year in the off-season program, which we got started, you know, in November, and they worked like dogs. I'm telling you, they worked and worked and worked. And the strength of our ball club was its strength, and it was through the off-season program and the work in the summer. And it's going to be a challenge to our group of juniors to follow their lead, and I know they will.
Well, I was going to say the baton now is passed to the next generation, so to speak. As we saw a couple of weeks ago, Got a lot of talent coming up in the junior high, the middle school, the JV programs, and I know that you'll be looking to several of those juniors that you just talked about to take that baton and become the leaders for next year's team.
Well, you know, we've got a fine nucleus to start from. We're going to have some help from our junior varsity, but offensively, Cliff Dameron and Mark Beggart will be back, and of course Andrew Woodward will be our quarterback, and Trey Smith played a bunch this year. You know, that's a good nucleus right there. Todd Williams played a bunch as tight end, so you got about five kids there offensively to build around. Where we're going to really need the help is in the offensive line, and we've got some kids like Charlie Gale and Doak Story and a couple others that really have good frames, but right now they don't have the physical strength that's going to be necessary. That can be developed. And defensively, you start with George Knoll and Matt Love. Those guys really played well, and were starters, you know, all year long. And so that's a good nucleus right there. And Jay Ellis. Jay Ellis played so much all year long. So you've got a good nucleus there. We're going to have to, we really need Mikey Summers to come back off that ankle surgery because our defensive line has been depleted. And Mikey is he's a key player. And if he comes back from his surgery fine, you put him in there with George and Jay and Matt, really gives us a good nucleus.
Well, Coach, can I assume then that since you've talked about finishing up your 19th year here, that we're going to take it right on to 20. That's a nice nice round number.
I hope so.
Milestone.
You know, that'll be something that I won't have any control over, but as far as I'm concerned, right now it's disappointing, and, Friday night, the thoughts that go through your mind, are not quite as severe on Saturday, and then by Sunday you start rebounding. We'll give the kids a little time off, and
sure.
Then we'll get ready for the next season. I do want to congratulate Jim Mauser and the girls cross country team. They won a state championship, and they overcame so much adversity this year. Had a lot of injuries, and the girls just hung tough in there. And I believe the boys wound up 10th in state. So quite a remarkable effort, you know. And of course the team tennis finished as a runner-up in the state. So this fall, we've gotten off to a great start. I just hope that it continues like that for the rest of the school year, and maybe we can get back in the playoffs next year in football.
You going to go out and watch any of the playoff action now that your team has wrapped it up? Be a lot of games going on, or are you just going to put that off to one side for a while?
Oh, I don't know.
Hard to say.
When we get eliminated from the playoffs, it's hard for me to go watch somebody else because you just...
It'd be kind of hard to follow Dennison around from here on out.
You just wish that you were there, and, it's... I'll probably go to a game or two. Though.
You know, if I live to be 100 years old, I certainly hope I do, I'm never going to forget the ultimate low and the ultimate high that all came in a span of, like, a couple of minutes at the end of that Dennison football game, when the ball was intercepted, returned for the touchdown, and then you realize there's the penalty back at the other end of the field. To me, you know, that just epitomizes how high you can be and yet how low you can go, all just in a matter of seconds. And yet that's one of the things that makes football such an exciting game and keeps everybody coming back.
Yep, it sure does. It makes you old, and then it infuses some youth into you. And being around these kids with such a great attitude that we had, it makes it all worthwhile.
All right, well, we're still smiling even though the season is over, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Really enjoyed working with you this year, and we'll see you again next season.
Thank you.
All right, and so long, everybody.
We used to laugh. We used to cry. Bow our heads, then wonder why. Now you're gone, I guess I'll carry on. Make the best of what you left to me. Left to me.
brought to you in part by Ellen Terry Realtors, where being a part of Ellen Territory is more than just selling real estate. And by the following special sponsors.
Overseas Motors. Since 1957, Overseas Motors has delivered the finest automobiles in Dallas. Rolls-Royce, Bentley, and Jaguar.
Hey, 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 hey Wonderful.
What a great stocking stuffer.
Yeah.
Okay, it's Fuller's Jewelry for me this Christmas.
Yeah, but you better do it now, Jerry. This sale ends Saturday, and these prices won't be repeated this year.
Gee, thanks, Bonnie. Want to share my processed kibble?
I think I'll just stick with donuts. Thank you.
We treat you like one of the family. Fuller's Jewelry Store.
Fuller's Jewelry, Marshall Ingle Avenue, across from Redbird Mall.
It's Wednesday afternoon. The Northtown boys soccer team is playing their weekly game. And like every Wednesday, as he promised, Jim Martin has come to see his son play. What's different about this particular Wednesday is that Jim Martin's car is in the shop being serviced. This could be a problem, except for the fact that Jim bought his car at Sewell Village Cadillac. So when he dropped his car off, he got a free loan car to use. A free loan car may seem like a small thing when you're buying a car, but at Sewell Village Cadillac, we understand how important a promise is, whether it's providing you with the best service possible or making it to a Wednesday afternoon soccer game. Don't you deserve Sewell service? Sewell Village Cadillac Sterling, Sewell Oldsmobile, and Sewell Hyundai. Ask the person who drives one.
Stereo 103.
Something I can give in exchange for everything you give to me. Read my mind, you make me feel just fine when I think my peace of mind is out of reach. Scales are sometimes unbalanced, and you bear the weight of all that has to be. I hope you see that you can lean on me, and together we can calm the stormy sea. When love's so strong and so unselfish, and I tell you now that I made a vow.
Grand Prairie Exchange, and it turned out to be the Cigna Health Plan office of some kind, and they had a machine on saying, you know, the office was closed. However, if you had a medical emergency, if you were a member, you know, press 2. If you had a medical emergency or something, press 1. So we figured that it was certainly winning the People's Choice Cash was came under the category of some kind of emergency. So we pressed the number 1, and after a while, the nurses came on, and this is what happened. I identified myself, and...
Okay, I'll get.
Okay.
$5,123.55.
Well, not quite that much, but I'm sure you would appreciate it anyway. We had $1,130.
Oh, well, see, I was close.
There's a clock ticking, a crime clock that's ticking away the minutes, even seconds, between crimes in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. Now more than ever before, our homes are targets for burglars and vandals. They work in broad daylight or in the still of the night.
Sergeant, this is Brinks Home Security. Reporting an intrusion.
Brinks is already protecting over 80,000 homes coast to coast. Why? Because Brinks has made home protection affordable. It costs only $19.50 per month for Brinks Home Security. Only $19.50 per month after a low one-time connection fee. Protect your home, your family, and your property. At only $19.50 per month, you can't afford to be without Brinks 24-hour protection. Call Metro 214-263-9111. Brinks Home Security. That's Metro 214-263-9111.
John, quit looking at your watch.
But our meeting's in 1 hour. That new account hinges on this presentation.
Don't worry. With Cafe Royal's new 55-minute business lunch, we'll be able to enjoy our meal and make it to the meeting in time.
You know, my wife and I love Cafe Royal for dinner, but I never thought of coming here for lunch.
Well, they've made some new changes for lunch. It's less formal and less expensive.
Cafe Royal announces their new luncheon menu, guaranteed not to slow you down. Now you can enjoy the outstanding food Cafe Royal is famous for, but with a lighter touch. Choose between a fixed price lunch in 55 minutes or any of the new a la carte items, from fresh winter salads to pasta dishes to grilled tuna. And with their fixed price business lunch, you can be in and out within 55 minutes or your lunch is free. When dining alone, ask for their new Royal table and enjoy complimentary newspapers along with your meal. Cafe Royals reduce the price and the time it takes for lunch. Located in the Plaza of the Americas, downtown Dallas.
Sarah, your choice for lunch was a winner.
Just like our proposal?
Right.
Attention, please. This message carries a heavy responsibility. Sears is offering free shipping and handling on catalog orders placed for pickup at your local Sears catalog department. Now is the time to take care of weighty matters and order that heavy merchandise or place that big order for Christmas, because there is no charge for shipping and handling on all catalog orders placed from November 16th through the 19th. It's to show our appreciation to you for making Sears the largest catalog retailer. Call now or visit Sears Catalog Order Department.
Monday early morning on KVIL, we found prize catalog winner number 11.
907-3304.
That was the number announced by Ron Chapman for a choice from the catalog K-Line. And with that number...
My name is Wayne Lee.
And now Wayne will choose from 8 cars, trips to Moscow, Greece, Monte Carlo, a C-Ray 20-foot powerboat, or 2 $20,000 shopping sprees.
Can't believe it.
Now, the addition of Wayne, who, by the way, does accounting at the AA Majors Company in Dallas, and whom you probably noticed is a rather unflappable sort, makes a running total of 11 catalog wins.
I've been listening to you guys for many years.
Each of whom felt as both Wayne and you have from time to time.
Didn't think I'd ever win anything.
Each of whom will now tell you the key is keeping the faith.
You have to believe.
So, as Wayne Lease of Flower Mound makes his calculations...
That'll be one of these trips.
...and finds himself with a surplus...
Of course, that $20,000 shopping spree doesn't look too bad.
The catalog numbers add up to yet another celebration. Where?
One place I can get a Long Island tea.
From the catalog accounts payable people here at...
your man, and she won't have to worry. She'll dress up all in lace and go in style. Late at night, a big old house gets lonely. I guess every form of refuge has its price. And it breaks her heart to think her love is only given to a man with hands as cold as ice. So she tells him she must go out for the evening to comfort an old friend who's feeling down. But he knows where she's going and she's leaving. She is headed for the cheating side of town. You can't. Herself a strong one, stares out at the stars up in the sky. Another night, it's gonna be a long one. She draws a shade and hangs her head to cry. She wonders how it ever this crazy. She thinks about a boy she knew in school. Did she get tired or did she just get lazy? She's so far gone she feels just like a fool. My oh my, you sure know.
KVIL, 18 and a half minutes in front of 9. This is Lynn Haley. In case you missed it, Bob Adams of the Adams Pharmacy in DeSoto ripped us off for $2,590. That happened on the Jack Shell Show. And, you know, Bob's on the phone here now. You know, he runs the pharmacy. He's probably a pharmacist himself, and he owns the place. And I know that Bob's community-minded, and he's going to be thinking of the betterment of for the less fortunate, especially during the holiday season, and now he has this extra cash, and I just know that he's going to be putting the money, you know, where it's really needed. As I said, he's on the phone. So how are you, Bob?
Good. I just want to thank y'all for getting me a trip out to Vegas now.
Oh, is that what you're going to do with the money?
Yeah.
Well, Bob, I guess you own the pharmacy there?
Yes, ma'am.
So I guess you're really hurting for cash.
Yeah, really. So see, now this gave me a chance to get out there.
Oh, so when are you going?
Thursday morning.
You've already got eyes.
I went ahead and booked it. I said, what the heck, charge it.
I call them Tingle Bells, because every time I hear them, those holiday sensations begin, and I see the tree lights and smell the pine. Oh, I can almost taste that Christmas turkey now. So what do? I'm no Scrooge. I just grab my bag and gift list in hand and head for the mall. I love discovering something that will make their eyes light up, making them happy. That's what it's all about. And what's that? A sled? Reindeer? Oh my gosh, here comes Santa Claus!
Don't settle for part of it. Irving Mall, get you the heart of it.
This Saturday morning at 9, Santa Claus arrives at Irving Mall in the food court. You can have breakfast with him for just a dollar. Have your picture taken with him. Meet Poppy and Bonkers, the Channel 27 clowns. And enjoy mimes, a magic show, and lots more. Irving Mall, on Highway 183 at Dupline Road North in Irving.
You're looking for more than you can find it.
What makes you trust a doctor, or even simply like a doctor? Is the test how long you're kept waiting? The diplomas on the wall, the way your questions are answered? We all have different ways of judging and choosing a doctor, and nothing is more personal or more important than the doctor-patient relationship. So you'll be glad to know there's a health care plan designed to take your feelings into consideration. The MaxiCare Health Plan. Yes, it's the health plan that doesn't require a deductible or a claim form. It's the health plan that pays all your medical expenses when you're hospitalized, not just 80%, and never charges you more than a few dollars for a doctor's office visit, and often absolutely nothing. But perhaps the most important advantage of the MaxiCare health plan is that you choose your MaxiCare doctor, and you choose him or her the only correct way, your way.
The MaxiCare health plan.
Again this Thursday, KVIL people hit the streets carrying cash. Yes, this Thursday is yet another KVIL Take Your Radio to Work Day. From early morning to well into the evening, we'll be looking and listening for radio set on 103.7 FM KVIL. If we find you on Thursday, it's a crisp $50 bill. And yes, we do look everywhere. East, west, north, south, from the big buildings to the itty-bitty boutiques. If we find you and you're listening, you win. Thursday, the return of a KVIL original, another Take Your Radio to Work Day, as we try to reward you for doing what you're probably doing right now, listening at work. And as we continue to make sure that...
Everyone's coming up winner on
back to the floor that I love.
10 and a half minutes in front of 9 o'clock. This is Linda Haley. Yeah, Bob Adams, $2,590 richer on his way to Vegas. That's what the money's for, you know. Unexpected money, do with as you please. And hopefully he will put it to good use. We'll find out. He promised me he'd let me know if he wins or loses or what. We'll have a follow-up report on this. After 9 o'clock, we have another People's Choice call coming up. Also, we have the shoes. Yeah, the Nike cross-training shoes. And that wonderful review of the Amtrak ride to Houston. Don't go anywhere.
The best deals on the best wheels are at Champion Ford Truck Center, 2 miles south of LBJ on Central at Meadow Road. Come to Champion Ford, apply the appropriate factory rebate, and buy an 88 Ranger for as little as $64.88. Or check out Champion Savings on an 89 F-150 with Texas package and air conditioning, just $89.88. How about an 89 Aerostar for $99.88 or a Bronco 2 with air, just $10,399. Now that's a $3,400 discount. All you add is tax, title, and license. The best deals on the best wheels are at the Champion Ford Truck Center, and we prove it with this challenge. Bring us your best written offer. We'll beat it, or we'll give you the difference in cash.
That's incredible.
No, that's Champion Ford.
Our middle name is quality at a price you can afford. When it comes to saving money, come to Champion Ford. We're here to save you money. At Champion Ford.
2 miles south of LBJ on Central at Meadow Road.
Primacare Medical Center.
Hi, you don't give flu shots, do you?
Yes, we do.
Oh.
Is that you, Mr. Davis?
No, it's not. He's in Waco, or Bora Bora.
But I...
No, this is his mom. I mean his wife person.
Well, flu season is on the way.
Yeah, I mean, yes.
So please tell Mr. Davis he can get his flu shot anytime. You never need an appointment at Primacare.
Right, well, maybe he'll call me.
From Bora Bora?
Oh, sure, he has a bass drum.
Excuse me?
Well, it is long distance.
If you've put off getting a flu shot because you think it's too much trouble, we make it easy at Primacare. We're open every day from 8 a.m. till 10 p.m., even holidays. And there's always a doctor on duty at each of our 15 convenient locations, along with medical laboratory and x-ray facilities. Plus, you never need an appointment at Primacare, so you can get your flu shot just about any time. Primacare Medical Centers, along with Presbyterian Hospital of Dallas, a member of the Presbyterian Healthcare System. Primacare, right where you need us, when you need us.
Well, gossip about this pair next on KVIL.
Nothing lived, nothing grew, till I loved you. Every sky, ever gray, never blue. You were my friend, good friend, and sometimes I would wonder, could the one to save me possibly be you?
I was lost, I was blind, till I let you. Wouldn't see, couldn't find someone new. You were my friend, dear friend. I held you close to my heart, but I never thought I'd feel the way I do.
Until that certain moment.
Lynn Haley at 4.5 minutes in front of 9 o'clock. Yeah, on page 2D of today's USA Today under the People heading, they allude to the fact that Don and Barbara are no longer together. No longer together. So here's some words of the wisdom here. And they're still laughing on the record, but they're no longer together. So this means that you should never, with that special person in your life, never hang curtains with them, never teach them how to drive, and never have a hit record.
To me, fall is the best time of year in Texas for a lot of reasons. There's football and all those great holidays when the family gets together, and the money you can save on a new Carrier heating and cooling system. Now, you may think it's strange to be thinking of air conditioning at this time of year, but think about this. It's the off-season, so you get faster installation and rebates of up to $400 on selected air conditioners and furnaces from the Super 7. Seven Carrier dealers who've been serving Dallas an average of 40 years each, offering 24-hour service 7 days a week on any brand of air conditioner or furnace. Their servicemen respond promptly, fix it right the first time, and charge a fair price. Who are the Super 7? Well, there's Kirk Air Conditioning, Spencer Air Conditioning, Ace Furnace Company, B&B Air Conditioning, Dallas Plumbing Company, Dring Engineering, and MB Kaiser Air Conditioning. Just look in the phone book for one of the Super 7 Carrier dealers. If you think you need a new Carrier system, ask about Carrier's money-saving rebates and excellent terms. See, I told you fall was a good time to think of air conditioning.
Welcome to your participating Bridgestone Tire Dealers, not just another tire sale celebration.
And just in time, too, Lou. Passing below us is a remarkable 1,000 accordions marching band.
And equally amazing, Norm, is that right now, selected Bridgestone tires are on sale until November 27th.
Speaking of tires, Lou, the band is forming one. Yes, it is. They're forming Bridgestone Series 300 Radio.
Well, that's right, Norm. Its unique Arcot design provides excellent wet and dry handling and braking.
Now they're forming what appears to be a really big stick.
No, Norm. They're reminding the crowd with only a finger's width of tire between them and the road, they need Bridgestone confidence.
That's pretty good for an accordion band.
Well, you can't forget the baton twirlers.
I don't plan to.
Remember, folks, save on selected Bridgestone tires during your Bridgestone dealer's Not Just Another Tire Sale through November 27th.
Stop by and save on Bridgestone tires at the Montgomery Ward Auto Express Center nearest you. Or check your yellow pages for the participating Bridgestone tire dealer in your area.
Now Estee Lauder Laboratories takes skin care as far as our modern technology can go. Introducing Future Perfect Micro-Targeted Skin Gel. This microsome formula gives your skin luminosity of younger skin. Digitized image analysis developed for the space program shows the actual improvement in the appearance of lines, wrinkles, and smoothness. Try it and feel the future working for you.
Now at Marshall Fields.
Oh, it's something from our classic oldie collection. CSNN on KVIL.
It's getting to the point where I'm no fun anymore.
I am sorry.
Sometimes it hurts so badly I must cry out loud.
I am lonely.
I am yours. You are mine. You are what you are. You make it hard.
Tearing yourself away from me now, you are free, and I am crying. This does not mean I don't love you, I do, that's forever, yes, and for always.
I am yours, you are mine, you are what you are. You make it hard. Friday evening, Sunday in the afternoon. What have you got to lose? Tuesday morning, please be gone, I'm tired of you.
you got to lose.